Very interesting things. She read aloud from the school, so we were, that's how well it was, so I was in my head. Funny, you know, we read aloud, she read the walls. And the wildflowers were so beautiful, she didn't like people who came to visit us, and that wildflowers were called pretty weeds, because they grow such beautiful wildflowers, more beautiful than anything would be in a forest shop. Wonderful.
There's this story I've been meaning to tell you. It's about my mom.
Hello.
And it's about her mom. It started when my mom was a little girl. And it's still going on today. One day I asked my mom, Mother, why didn't your mother like you very much?
No one could tell what she was thinking. She has such a serenity and composure. A beautiful smile.
No.
No. No. No. No.
I guess my mother never loved me. I guess
no.
My father never cared.
No.
Or why would she take me deep in the woods?
No.
And why would she have trees for cover, but without a father or a mother, the woods loom like a dangerous brother. Witches, niches sublime, ogres, ghouls, goblins, and grime, roots that press downward through time. From mother to daughter in rhyme, threads of ivory, threads of gold, stories told and retold, branches young and old. Through generations unfold. Hands of a baby, of a crone, I need a life I can call my own, bark and branches, skin and bone. These woods have become my home. Pretty girl, light as a stone, are you in these woods alone? Pretty girl, light as a stone, are you in these woods alone.
One morning, Mom said she dreamt that she had been chased again and saved by a woman who looked like she had looked when she was younger.
Supper.
Are you a good witch or a bad witch?
I'm not always sure.
What is it?
Rampion.
I like it.
Seeing you takes me back to when I was you.
But I'm not you.
Perhaps.
I was told I was the filmmaker's mother and occasionally the filmmaker.
I play several roles as well. Are you full? Let's clean you up.
She has burrowed so deeply inside of her shell that no one can see her and no one can tell. I can still feel the silence that covered her cries as I gazed into my mother's sad eyes. She ruled a deep world in a shadowy sea that pinched at her sides, dug its teeth into me. Though I know it could never be, it would be wild if I played my mother and she played the child.
What is your name?
I don't know.
Oh, Rapunzel. That's the story.
Rapunzel? I don't know if I like that name.
Rapunzel.
What should I call you?
Mother.
Mother.
Once my mother had this dream she thought belonged to me.
Mother, where are you going?
I'm looking for something I lost.
One night, long ago at bedtime, I looked at my mom, and I remember thinking that what we both needed was a mother, one who was brave and who never closed her eyes.
Sweet dreams.
When I have bad dreams, I disappear.
Don't disappear.
Tell me the story about the girl who shed her skin.
some bedtime story. It was a dream that took place over many nights. A young girl walked into her mother's bedroom and shed her skin. It shook as though it were alive. She felt all nerves and walked out into the night, raw as meat. The night was filled with the cries of her heart, voices she was afraid to hear. She hugged the ground, afraid she'd fall off, disappear, and never come back. I liked you better the way you were.
Just who does she think she is, anyway? I wonder what's in this box.
Oh, Rapunzel? Where did that girl go?
I bet I'd be a knockout in this. She's stashed down here.
Rapunzel.
I knew I didn't like that name.
I'm going to work. You stay here. It's not safe for you outside. No, it's not safe for you.
Once Mom told me about this dream she used to have. She'd dress herself up and slip out the door. He'd be waiting there.
Horses, Mr. Prince Charming.
Mother, where am I?
Hush. You'll be safe here.
I don't want to be safe. I want to see that boy again.
be ridiculous. He's nothing better than a tramp.
Look, I'm not your little girl anymore.
Shut up, you little fool. That's no Prince Charming.
He was disarming, she was alarming. Her Prince Charming was so. Gnarling and snarling, snarling and gnarling. Her
Let
Prince
me out!
Was so. Someday my true love will come. Someday my true love will come. Will he be fun? Will he be glum? Will he be sad? Will he be mad? Someday one day my one love will come. Then will I sigh, then will I cry, then will he punch me in the eye. Mother's afraid I'll get hurt, but locking me up doesn't.
You never loved me, you only
but
love
locking
yourself.
Locking me up doesn't
come out of the ground. In the dark they arise, a vast and silent force that cradles a child, that cradles the corpse.
Old woman, my mother, my child, my friend. So many beginnings, so close to the end.
No.
No?
No.
No, well...
Yes. I could end up like you.
Ah, ah.
On her 80th birthday, Mother finally got free. She sold her house and walked away. And this was no dream. Mother, did you really tell them that you've left home?
And I'm never coming back.
There was a woman who hobbled along, who'd learned all the words to a very sad song. Mother wanted to swing free and to play ball. And here